So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. So in today's class, we'll be talking about the PIB news from 21st to 22nd of June 2023. Alright, so without any delay, let's begin with the class and there are very less news today. So I decided ki ek scheme kar lete hai. To ek scheme jo ki bahut hi important hai that we are going to discuss today, right? So let's begin with the class guys and let's talk about the very first question. Which platform has been launched by National Highway Authority of India for inclusive development of national highways by collaborating with experts and citizens? So you just have to tell the name of the platform which has been launched by NHAI, National Highways Authority of India. Remember, the name of the platform is just the knowledge sharing platform, right? So it's the National Highway Authority of India which has launched a knowledge sharing platform for inclusive development of national highways, right? This will help in inclusive development of the national highways, right? Now this platform will help the authority to collaborate with the experts and citizens who want to share their knowledge and expertise and experience in the area of road design, construction, road safety, environment sustainability, etc. And that's why the name knowledge sharing platform. Okay, this will encourage share of best practices from around the world. Aisa nahi hai ki sirf India ke hi log isme knowledge share kar payenge. It will be, you know, it will allow the foreign people also to share their best practices and will contribute towards the holistic development of the national highways. All right. So that's it. Itna hi hai. The correct answer will be option C, knowledge sharing platform. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 2. Ministry of Women and Child Development has taken a decision to integrate Women Helpline and Child Helpline with ERSS 112. What is this ERSS 112? Emergency Response Support System. Emergency Response Support System. It is a response support system of Ministry of Home Affairs. Emergency Response Support System. So now the Women Helpline and Child Helpline will be integrated with ERSS 112. In how many states or UTs the integration of the helpline will be done in phase 1? All right. So it is the Ministry of Women and Child Development currently headed by Smriti Zubin Irani which has taken a decision to integrate Women Helpline and Child Helpline with ERSS 112. This integration guys will be done under the Mission Vatsalya scheme which we have discussed in very much detail in the government schemes revision classes. All right. Now what will happen? Child Helpline will be running in coordination with state and district functionaries including police, counselors, case workers, and CDAC Kerala, Center for Development of Advanced Computing of Kerala, has been entrusted as the total solution provider for the automation of Child Helpline and its integration with ERSS. Alright, so which organization will be the sole, will have the responsibility of doing all this? It's CDAC Kerala. Okay? In the first phase, 9 states or UTs will be covered for integration and this will be done by 30th of June 2023. And yes, you have to remember the date. Yes, you have to remember the date. And these 9 states and UTs where this integration will be done in phase 1 are Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal Pradesh, Bihar, Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, Gujarat, Goa, Ladakh, Mizoram and Puducherry. And other states or UTs will also be covered in phase wise manner. Okay. So that is all about it. And the correct answer therefore is option D, 9. Question number 3. National Internet Exchange of India recently celebrated its 20th Foundation Day. It is a not-for-profit Section 8 company under the aegis of which ministry? So under which ministry does NICSI work? Right? So it has recently celebrated its 20th Foundation Day. And remember, NICSI was established in the year 2003. 2003 to increase the internet penetration across the country. The major objective is to increase internet penetration and adoption in India by facilitating various infrastructure aspects to enable internet ecosystem, right? So basically developing the infrastructure and thereby enhancing the penetration and adoption of internet across the country. And of course it works as a not-for-profit Section 8 company under the Ministry of Electronics and IT headed by Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. All right, this much information is enough and therefore the correct answer is Ministry of Electronics and IT. All right. Now let's talk about this scheme. Very, very important. Consider the following statements with respect to credit guarantee fund scheme for micro and small enterprises and you need to identify the correct statement. So this scheme was in news because of the recent amendments made in it राइट, तीन मेजर अमेंडमेंट इसमें इसके अंदर हुए थे। द क्रेडिट गारंटी लिमिट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड अप टू रुपीज 5 crores। द एनुअल गारंटी फी हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड टू एज लो एज 0.37% एंड 8000 crores have been infused into the fund, right? So that's why it becomes very, very important. So let's talk about the scheme. It is the Credit Guarantee Fund scheme for micro and small enterprises. For micro and small enterprises. So as the name says, it is a credit guarantee fund scheme, which means it provides credit guarantee to the micro and small enterprises. And of course, actually जो क्रेडिट गारंटी मिल रही है वो किसको मिल रही है? फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस को, विच आर प्रोवाइडिंग लोन टू दीज माइक्रो एंड स्मॉल एंटरप्राइजेस, राइट। क्रेडिट गारंटी का मतलब क्या होता है मैं बता देता हूँ। लेट्स से देयर इज एन एमएसएम, देयर इज अ माइक्रो एंटरप्राइज एक्स विच हैज टेकन अ लोन ऑफ लेट्स से 1 crore फ्रॉम अ शेड्यूल कमर्शियल बैंक, एंड लेट्स से इन एनी केस ड्यू टू एनी सर्टेन रीजन एक्स हैज फेल्ड टू पे बैक दिस लोन, ठीक है। तो इन दैट केस दिस 1 crore सर्टेन परसेंटेज, ऑफ कोर्स इसका कुछ परसेंटेज है, वो परसेंटेज हम बात करेंगे अभी। जो भी परसेंटेज होगा दैट विच परसेंटेज विल बी रीपेड बाय द क्रेडिट गारंटी फंड स्कीम थ्रू द क्रेडिट गारंटी फंड ट्रस्ट विच हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड अंडर दिस स्कीम। ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज द होल आइडिया ऑफ दिस स्कीम। इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2000 बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एमएसएमई, एंड टू ऑपरेशनलाइज दिस स्कीम गवर्नमेंट एंड सिडबी हैव सेट अप अ क्रेडिट गारंटी फंड ट्रस्ट फॉर माइक्रो एंड स्मॉल एंटरप्राइजेस विच लुक आफ्टर the you know credit guarantee. All right, now credit guarantee credit facilities eligible under the scheme, basically jo hamare jitne bhi financial institutions hai unke liye ek limit hai. So the trust covers credit facilities extended by the member lending institutions to a single eligible borrower in MSE sector for credit facility not exceeding rupees 50 lakhs in case of RRBs, select financial institutions and microfinance institutions, not exceeding rupees 2 crores in case of small finance bank, scheduled urban cooperative banks including non-scheduled UCBs, state cooperative banks and district central cooperative bank, and it should not exceed rupees 5 crores in case of public sector banks, private sector banks, foreign banks and other selected financial institutions, right? So these limits you have to remember, these are important. Maximum guarantee coverage, as I already told you in beginning, it has been extended from 2 crores to 5 crores per borrower, and the tenure of guarantee cover is 5 years. The member lending institution can apply for guarantee cover any time during the tenure of loan. Kabhi bhi wo apply kar sakta hai us guarantee ke liye, right? What is the extent of guarantee coverage? So the percentage which I was talking about, so if it is a micro enterprise, for the loan up to rupees 5 lakh rupees 85 guarantee coverage is provided. For the loan between above 5 lakh and up to rupees 50 lakh, 75% of the amount will be credited in case the micro enterprise default. For the loan above rupees 50 lakh and up to rupees 500 crore, it's 75%. While if it is the case of micro and small enterprises located in northeastern region, including Sikkim, UT of Jammu Kashmir and UT of Ladakh, for the loan up to rupees 50 lakh, the percentage is 80%, while above 50 lakh and up to 500 lakh or 5 crores, it is again 75%. If it is the case of women entrepreneurs, SCST entrepreneurs, PWD entrepreneurs, or MSME promoted by Agni Veers, right, or MSME situated in aspirational district, or Z certified MSEs, theek hai, MSME nahi hai, sari jagah MSE hai, micro and small, medium ke liye ye scheme nahi hai. If it is a Z certified MSEs also, in all the cases, for loans up to rupees 5 crore, 85% of the credit guarantee coverage is provided to the financial institution. While in the rest of the category borrower, 75% of the credit guarantee is provided. This, guys, is very, very important. Ye bahut zyada important table hai, aapko yaad rakhni hai. Now, the eligible activities are 4, which are manufacturing, services, trading, wholesale, either wholesale or retail, and educational or training institution. However, the activities which are not under the ambit of this scheme are self-help groups and agricultural activities. Okay, and talking more about it, so there is an annual guarantee fee as well, which has been reduced to as low as 0.37%. So for loan from 0 to 2 lakh, it is 0.37%. For loan 10 to above 10 to 50 lakh, 0.55%. Above 50 lakh to 1 crore, 0.60%. Above 1 crore to 2 crores, 1.20 crores and above 2 crores and up to 5 crores, it is 1.35%. All right. And there is the annual guarantee fee concessions as well. So if it is the case of women or SC or ST or PWDs or Agniveer promoted MSC, 10% का annual guarantee fee concession मिलता है, ठीक है? Like for example, 100 का अगर guarantee fee लग रहा है, तो 90 rupees उनको देना पड़ेगा, alright? While if it is the case of MSC registered in northeastern region including Sikkim, UT of Jammu Kashmir and Ladakh, up to rupees 50 lakh, और या फिर aspirational district है तो 10%, और if it is a Z certified MSME, then it is again 10%, okay? So that is all guys about this scheme. I hope this scheme is clear and बहुत important है. I believe ये exam में इसमें से कोई question आना चाहिए. The scheme was launched in 2000 by the Ministry of MSME. बिल्कुल सही बात है. The fund has been infused with 8,000 crores. बिल्कुल सही. Maximum guarantee coverage limit is available up to 5 crores per borrower. ये भी बात ठीक है. And only manufacturing and service activities are eligible. No. There are two more activities, trading or educational. So 1, 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. 1, 2 and 3 option D. Because we need to identify the correct statement. Alright. And now let's talk about the questions in short. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this class, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is provided in the description. And very important update here is that we have launched the past year paper book, which contains past year paper book hai. जिसके अंदर 2010 से लेके 2022 तक के पेपर है, विच कंटेन्स द पास्ट ईयर पेपर फ्रॉम 2010 टू 2022, एंड द क्वेश्चंस आर प्रोवाइडेड विद डिटेल्ड सॉल्यूशन. एंड टू बाय दैट बुक यू कैन विजिट Amazon और यू कैन विजिट आवर वेबसाइट anujjindal.in. ठीक है जी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, विद विच मिनिस्ट्री हैज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स हेडेड बाय अर्जुन मुंडा हैज कोलैबोरेटेड टू सप्लाई 34,000 योगा मैट्स procured exclusively from the tribal artisans across different regions of the country. So the ministry in question is Ministry of Ayush. Option D is the correct answer. Question number 6, Drug Controller General of India, DGCI. Can you tell me who is the current DGCI of the country? Write down in the comment section, kaun hai abhi current DGCI? Has approved indigenously developed Omicron specific mRNA based booster vaccine, which is GemcoVac, for emergency use authorization under Mission COVID Suraksha. Which ministry is implementing Mission COVID Suraksha? That is the question. It is not the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, but it is the Ministry of Science and Technology, headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 7, NHPC Limited, which is India's largest hydropower development organization, recently participated in 91st annual meeting of International Commission on Large Dams. Where did the meeting take place? Meeting kahan pe hui thi? The meeting took place in Sweden at a place which is known as Gothenburg. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 8, which country has piloted recently adopted resolution by United Nations General Assembly to establish a new memorial wall for fallen peacekeepers? This country in question is Aar Pyara Bharat. India is the correct answer. Option B. Question number 9, what is the name of electronic signage system that have been installed across the court complexes of high courts to inform the stakeholders about court related key parameters and bring awareness among public by providing bird eye view of court related data? So right, every data will be, each data will be provided there, and the name of this electronic signage system is Justice Clocks. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 10, when was Aadhaar based scheme for online submission of digital life certificates, that's Jeevan Praman, right? What is the name of this initiative, Jeevan Praman, launched by the Ministry of Personal Public Grievances and Pensions to ensure transparency and ease of living for pensioners? From this particular platform, they can obtain the digital life certificates and they do not have to visit the office of Tehsildars and other offices, right? This initiative was launched in the year 2014. Option A is the correct answer. And the last question for today, where was the World of Work Summit of ILO, International Labour Organization, on promoting social justice held? Kahan pe hua tha ye this summit? This summit took place at Geneva in Switzerland. Option A is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that is all for today. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And जो भी चीजें आपने पढ़ ली हैं अब तक रिवाइज करते रहो, प्लीज फोकस ऑन द रिविजन, डू नॉट रन आफ्टर द न्यू थिंग्स बिकॉज इट इज नॉट द राइट टाइम टू स्टडी न्यू थिंग्स, राइट? जस्ट फोकस ऑन रिविजन, रिवाइज रिवाइज एंड रिवाइज, ऑलराइट? And I will see you in the next class. Till then, keep studying and keep studying hard. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.